Fashion Friday, you guys. I hope you all had a great week. I had a little southern twinge there, right? That I said you all, right? That's for my southern girls. Anyways, I wanted to give you guys some plus size fashion tips today because I myself am a curvy girl. I've been curvy my entire life. And I feel like the fashion industry kind of doesn't make clothes or doesn't give really great tips for those of us who are curvy women. And so I wanted to give you some of the things that I've learned over the last several years that just work for me. And maybe it'll help some of you guys out there too. So step number one is to invest in some good undergarments. This is the number one question I get from you guys. You guys are all nosy about what my undergarments are. I'm not gonna lie. I always get the what bra do you wear and all that. I'm like, you guys wanna know what bra I wear? But my favorite one is by Caché. Those are the ones that I wear all the time. I would demonstrate, but it's a little not G-rated, so I'm not gonna show that for you guys today. But also the undergarments, I know a lot of you guys wear Spanx and that works, but for me, I don't know about you guys, the curvy girls, we need something a little stronger than Spanx. Do you know what I mean? You're gonna laugh, and I was gonna demonstrate it for you guys today, but I actually use compression garments sometimes. There's this one brand called Marlena, and I'll link to it below for you guys, and it's a compression garment that has snaps up the side, so it's super form-fitting, and it's not just for us curvy girls. If you are a smaller size as well, they have that for you, and it is amazing. It will cinch you in at least two dress sizes, and you know how with Spanx, you have to like, you're breaking out a sweat trying to get those suckers on. These don't do that because they zip up the side, they snap, so you can literally get yourself in there and cinch it in. So that's the first step, is to get really great undergarments that will smooth everything out, tighten everything, especially if you're wearing like a very form-fitting dress. And then step number two is to embrace your curves. I have been told my whole life that I can't wear certain things, and I'm so stubborn. If someone tells me I can't wear something, I'll wear it, just be like, you know what, I can wear it because you told me I can't, I'm going to now. So I love to tell all of my other curvy women to embrace your curves. Don't feel like you can't wear certain things. Pick something that is your favorite. Like for me, I feel like a really nice chest. So I like to wear things that maybe have like a V-neck cut up here, or maybe it's something that's a little form-fitting up top and then I'll go looser on the bottom. So whatever you feel like is your best curve area, embrace that and wear something that kind of accentuates that. Number three is one that I use all the time. If you guys see my Instagram, which is Marlena Style, by the way, you like how I'm pimping that out a little bit? You'll see I wear wide belts all the time. And it doesn't matter what body shape you are. If you are an hourglass shape, or if you're more of, I like to call it an emerald shape. It doesn't matter what your body type is. If you wear a belt in the center, especially a dark, thick one, it gives the illusion that it cinches it in, and it just gives you that natural way. So I swear by that all the time, and I will wear it with dresses, or even if I wear a high-waisted skirt with a really cute button up top, I'll put a belt in there as well, because it just draws your eye in and it gives you that illusion of that really small waist. Number four is one that gets overlooked so many times, and it's something it took me many years to figure out, and it's so easy. I'm like, why did I not do this before? But tailoring is your best friend, especially for me with jeans or pants. They never fit me off the rack. I always have to get them altered, and it's not that expensive at all, and it's a great investment. So I'll spend maybe $15, $20, and I'll get a great pair of jeans altered in at the waist, because my waist is much smaller than my thighs and hips. So I always do tailoring and get them taken in, especially where you need, so they look like they fit you like a glove, and it makes such a huge difference in how you feel in them, because they're more comfortable, they fit you perfectly, and it's so cheap and inexpensive. It's just a great investment for all of your clothes. Number five is avoid flimsy fabrics. And I know as I'm saying that, I'm wearing flimsy fabric right here, but the core pieces, especially in the center, like my camisole, my jeans, my pants, I like to have things that have a strong structure to them. Because if we curvy women start to wear things that are very thin fabric, it kind of shows certain parts that we don't want. Like for me, my problem area in my thighs, I have cellulite under there, which it's so common. It's not like a bad thing, but it's something I have to think about. And if I wear very thin fabric pants, it shows all of that. So I like to have something that has structure. It's very, a little bit stiff, so that way it kind of hangs off the skin a little bit better. I don't know if that makes sense at all, but definitely don't get anything that's super flimsy unless it's just maybe like a little cardigan or an over jacket, but all of your core pieces, have them be nice and stiff. Number 6 is all about monochromatic dressing, and you guys will see me do this a lot too, especially in black. I mean, who doesn't like wearing all black? It's easy, you don't have to think about it, it's slimming. Regardless of what color, if you wear monochromatic, especially for me in the center, I know you guys can't see my outfit, but I'm wearing a black bodysuit and I'm wearing black pants in the center, and then the outer part, I always wear a pop of color. But if you have that center all in one color, whether it be a deep plum, or we have some pieces that are called echo, we have like gray t-shirt, gray skirt. If you do all of that one color, what it does is it makes you look longer and leaner, and it just elongates your whole body and it just thins you out. So regardless of size, that's an amazing tip, is just to wear monochromatic from head to toe. Number 7 is to buy clothes that have stretch. Now, I swear everything in the Marste line has stretch to it. It was such a huge pet peeve of mine. I know I talked about a couple steps ago about having stiff fabric. You can still have very structured, thick fabric, but still have it be stretchy so that it conforms to your curves a little bit, and it's just more comfortable. Let's face it, ladies, I don't want to wear stuff that is so uncomfortable. If after 2 hours I want to rip it off my body, I'm not going to wear that shiznit the next day. I'm just not. So make sure you have something that has some stretch to it so it conforms to all of your curves. So that way, like if you have a waist or if you have like a nice set of legs or whatever, that you can accentuate that because the fabric actually conforms to that and has a little bit of stretch. Number 8 is to flaunt your favorite features. I know I talked about this a little bit, but for me, like I said, I have a nice chest. So I like to wear a V-neck. Some of you out there may have a great set of legs, so wear something that's a little bit shorter. Wear like kind of a mini skirt or a midi skirt, something that is slimmer there. Maybe you like your back. You have like a really beautiful back. Wear something that's low cutting in the back. Pick one feature that you feel is your strongest point and focus on that, and it just makes you feel sexier. It makes you feel more confident because you know what your strong points are, and rock it, flaunt it. That's all I'm gonna say on that one. Number 9, this one took me a few years to figure out. Patterns are your friend. I'm gonna repeat that because I know we all wear solids. Patterns are your friend. You see I'm wearing some patterns right here. We have the camo t-shirts and a couple other things that have patterns, but I used to be so afraid of wearing them, and I thought it would just make me look bigger, but it actually does the opposite. It kind of distracts the eye a little bit. So for me, my legs are a little bit thicker. And so I learned over the years that I could wear patterns on the bottom. Before I was like, oh, I can't wear that. It'll draw attention to them. It'll make me look so much bigger. But once I started wearing patterns on the bottom, it was like a mind trick or an eye trick. People would think that I was smaller in the bottom because the pattern is just a little bit deceiving. It kind of distracts from it. And then I wear a solid top on the top and it just balances everything out. So don't feel like just because you're plus size or you're curvy that you can't wear patterns. It's actually a really good thing. And just strategize whatever you feel like is an area that maybe you aren't as confident in, whether it be maybe it's your stomach or maybe it's your legs or whatever. Have that part be the pattern, and it kind of distracts it and takes away from that area. The last one is to avoid a high neckline. I hardly ever wear something that comes up to my neck. I'll wear turtlenecks every now and then, but if I do, I make sure that it's either shorter sleeve or I have something that's a little shorter on the bottom so I don't look like my grandma. I don't look matronly. But I am a huge believer in having a neckline. I just love showing an open neck. It doesn't mean that you have to do like the J-Lo from, what was it, the Grammys, where she had that super low cut thing. No. You don't have to be like inappropriate, but at least have some sort of open neckline so you can, it draws the eye up to your face and you can wear a beautiful necklace or put your hair up. It just brings more attention up. And I think it's just overall really flattering regardless of size. So that is my 10 tips for plus size fashion. And again, I'll have images on the Marste site for you guys so you can kind of get ideas. And I hope that you guys know how beautiful you are regardless of what size you are, what shape. I want you guys to feel like just because you are curvy that you can't be limited or that you're not valued as much just because of that. And I've been a curvy girl my whole life, and I feel like I'm so much more confident now even as a thicker girl because I've come to accept my body and love it and just have fun with fashion and not feel like I have to be limited at all. So that's kind of what all Marste is about, is just embracing every body size and body shape. So before I get emotional on that topic, we'll end it here. But thanks you guys for watching. Have an amazing weekend, and I'll see you next Fashion Friday. Bye. Number 6 is
Shut up with that.